Here is an overview of what we will be covering in the webinar today. I'll start with a general introduction about AHA, what it is and where you can get it. Then I will cover some other practicalities about using AHA, especially if this is your first time. I'll talk for about 35 to 40 minutes in total, and then there will be time for questions at the end. As I said before, in order to ask questions, you need to type it in. You can type the question at any time, but we'll pick them up at the end. Let's talk about R and RStudio. R is a statistical programming language for data analysis and statistics. R is free and open source, which means that there's a lot of people creating their own packages and programs around. It is available for Windows, Mac, and Linux machines, and is quite popular around the community. R has a huge community of users around the world that are willing to help you to solve doubts and questions. But R is a scripting language, which means that you have to write in code in order to do all your analysis. R is not as friendly and easy to work as you can see in the screen. That is why most people don't use R directly. Instead, we use RStudio, which is in an integrated development environment. It's also free and open source. RStudio is a user-friendly interface that keeps all the capabilities of R in a nice and organized screen. But RStudio acts as a mask for R, so in order to use RStudio, we need to have R installed in our machine. So here I put the links for both R and RStudio websites, so you can download them later if you haven't so done that yet. So this is the nice and organized interface of RStudio. It is a lot nicer than R, isn't it? It has a number of features that R doesn't have. So you can change the appearance. For instance, here is black, but you can have it in other colors. When you open RStudio, you will see four panels. Each of them plays an important role in RStudio. For instance, you can see the script editor and the console below the script, which is where all your code is being displayed. On the right side of the screen, you can see the R Environment Explorer, where we can see all the data that we are using and the variables and any object. And finally, we have the File Explorer, so we can explore our folders in our computers and files. There are all the tabs available there, where for instance, there is the help tab and the plot tab where we can see some previews of our graphs. So moving on from the description of the software, now I'll describe some practicalities that make our life easier with R. I'll start with scripts. Scripts is essentially a text file similar to a Word document where you write code. If you have experience using Stata, for instance, a script is the equivalent to a do file. You could write any code directly in the console, but the problem with writing your code in the console is that nothing that you write will be saved. So the main advantage is that the scripts can be reused in later sessions. They can also be copied and modified for changing our analysis and also for sharing with others. It's always a good practice to do your R code on a script, as it would help to keep track of what you have done. As you can see in the screen, you create a new script by clicking on the File tab, and then New File, and then select R script. To open a saved script, you just click Open File and search for it on your files, and then it's going to appear. For instance, this is a typical screen for the script. As you can see, you're writing the script directly. To run a code, you have to, to run a code in the script, you just click on a line of code or highlight several lines and click the run button there. Or you can click or select the line of code that you want and press Ctrl plus Enter in Windows or Command plus Alt plus R in Mac. I'm not a Mac user, so I'm not sure about that. In this case, the code that I have in my screen is to import a CSV file. Since I'm using the console and I'm importing a data set, the code it's not going to appear in my console, but it's going to appear in the environment, something like that. As I mentioned before, you have the option to of writing notes on your script. These notes can be a brief explanation of what you are doing, or you can also add some comments about the code that you are using, whether it worked or not, or anything. So let's talk now about the working directory. There is nothing fancy about that. It's just basically a folder, usually in your computer, where the data that we need to analyze is saved. In order to use R for data analysis, we need to tell R specifically where this folder is, so R can import the data for us. How do we tell R that where our working directory is? Well, we can use the function setWorkingDirectory that you see in your screen, followed by the path in your computer where the folder is. Or we can also use another easy way for getting the working directory is just asking R directly. So how we do that, we go to the session tab on the main window of our studio, and then set working directory, and then choose the directory that we want. After that, we get a screen where is displayed the working directory that we have set. So RStudio will set the working directory to your preferred location and display the set working directory function on the console. You can save the code for the next time. One of the most frequent questions that I get when I'm teaching R is that people doesn't know where the data is. That usually happens when people try to import data into R without setting the working directory first. So, but R is not very intelligent, so R doesn't look for the data set in your computer. It only looks on the working directory. And by default, R has a working directory, but it's never the one that we want. So we need to change it at the beginning. If you have problem, if you don't know what the working directory R is using, you can use the function getWorkingDirectory as shown there, and then it's going to show you where the working directory is. Now we are going to move to packages. Packages are a collection of R functions or data that are compiled in a well-defined format. An R package is simple, a bunch of data. It includes functions, it includes help menus, tutorials, examples that are stored in a neat package. R come with a standard set of packages already installed, but we need more of those packages when we are performing our analysis. For example, the packages having to import data in specific format like Stata, SPSS, or we also have the package ggplot2 that is for making graphs, or the package dmap for mapping. Once the package is installed, they have to be loaded into the session to be used. Here you can see the function that we use to install packages. So we use the function install.packages and then the name of the package. We can also use another easy way, that is just clicking onto the screen like this one. We go from the tools menu, then you search for the package, Intel packages, and then look for packages like that. So you can write the package that you're looking for and then press install. When you are installing a package, you will see a screen similar to this one, where in here I'm installing the packages called Tidyverse. It can take some time in install the packages depending on how big it is. After installing packages, R is not quite ready to do our analysis. We still need to do another step more, which is loading the packages into R, like this. We load packages using the function library, followed by the name of the package that we are loading. For instance, I'm loading here the Tidyverse package that I installed in the previous slide. The package Tidyverse is composed by several other packages like ggplot, tibble, tider, and other, tidyr. We can install all of them separately as well. You only need to install the package once, but you need to load them every time that you are using. You can load the package at any time and during your analysis. Just make sure that all the packages that you are using when you are doing some analysis are also in your script, so you know what you are doing for next time. So now I'm going to talk about data types and data structure. This is important because R have a different name for some widely known variables and data structures. So I won't be going into much detail with all of them. I just want to mention the most important ones, especially when you are looking for help in online, you're going to find that usually they use the word vector instead of variables or something like that. So for instance, let's go with the data types. We have character, which are just nominal variables, like for instance, female and male. This is what in status called string variables. We have also numeric, which are real or decimal number, like just number. Integer, as per definition, an integer is a whole number. For instance, 5 is an integer, but 5.1 is a decimal, so it's not an integer. And logical, which only takes value of true or false. So in data structures, we have vectors, which I said that are just variables. Factors, list, matrix, and data frame. Factors are the equivalent to, for instance, when you put a label to the variable sex, you have number 1 is for female, number 2 is for male. That's a factor variable for R. So variables are objects in R that store values. For instance, number 3 here is just a number, but when we assign the value 3 to the letter A, it became a variable, the variable A. I just mentioned the word assigned. In R, we can assign values to variables, we can assign variables to data set, we can assign labels to variables, and so on. To assign the value, we need a special character, well, a combination of two characters, as they highlighted there, which is called the assignment operator. You can do all sorts of operations with variables, such as multiplication, addition, etc. We can display the context of the variable by typing into the console, such in this example, with the variable v, which is just a multiplication of the variable vc divided by a. So what is vector? As I said before, are just variables, but they are defined as a single entity consisting of a collection of things. For example, a collection of letters, names, or a collection of numbers. So A is a vector as well. We create vector using the letter C for concatenating. For example, the typical variable age in any data set that we usually use, it is a vector. So we don't normally are going to be creating vectors, but it's good for you to know what we are talking about when you see the word vector around. As I said before, there are different type of vectors, such as character or string, numerical that only hold numbers, or logical when they are true or false, etc. Now we are moving on to data frames, or the data set properly. A data frame is a very important data type in R. To put it simple, it's just a series of rows and columns with headers indicating variable names and rows, numbers indicating case numbers. Tables, on the other hand, are also structured for storing tabular data. They are basically data frame, but just with some tweaks. But as you can see, tables are a bit more informative than data frames. And they immediately tell us the class of the variable, the type of variable. For instance, variable country is a character, the variable year is an integer, that kind of thing that a data frame doesn't give us. Tables also make easy to read the numbers by highlighting the thousand, as you can see there. But on the other hand, a data frame offer a bit cleaner view than tables, so it's up to you which one you want to use. Both type of data set are the same, it works the same in R, but tables are the de facto data frame type used with the package type diverse, because it works really, really well with Tidyverse. So why I'm telling you about these two types of tabular data? Just because data frames are the most well-known data structure in R, and probably you are already familiar with them. However, we will be using Tidyverse in the workshop, so when you are importing data, you are going to see the word table, and probably you are going to get confused, so I don't want you to produce that confusion. If you want to learn more about tables and data frames, you can just read the chapter 10, there is a link there, of the book R for Data Science. It's a very short chapter, like 3 pages, and there is a good explanation of the difference between table and data frame. So once we have set the working directory and have a better understanding of the data types and structures that we have, we can finally start bringing the data into R for some analysis. R can analyze almost any format, but we need to make sure that R will be able to read the data. There are a few packages used for importing data, for instance, the package Haven, the package Foreign, and the package Read R. So you can install them separately. Importing data using Foreign, for instance, will create a data frame, but if we use the packages Haven, we'll create a table, for instance. One of the advantages of using Haven is that because it works really, really well with labels with data sets from in Stata format on SPSS as well. So you have to use the right function to import the data frame. In this case, there are some examples using function readcsv or readdta for Stata files, or readcav for SPSS file. Another important thing is you have to name your data. Give your data a name, otherwise it's not going to be stored in R. So I'm going to here you can see how the R session looked like. I've set the working directory to my folder of choice, and you can see how the right-hand screen, the folders and files I have in my working directory. The data that I want to use are in the data webinar folder here. As I mentioned before, this file exploration, you can click in any folder there, and you can explore what you have there. So I'm going to show you the easy way to import data set in R. This way only works if we have the Tidyverse package installed and load. So in this case, we're going to focus on the File Explorer window. I just double click on the folder Data Webinar that I showed before, and where my data is saved. And I want to import the family composition data set that you can see there. So I just click on the name of the data, and RStudio is going to give me two options, view file and import data set. I just click on the name of the data, and I just press import data set, and the data is going to be imported. So this is the screen that we get after importing the data. As you can see, there is a preview of how the data looks like. As it uses the Tidyverse package, it's telling you that it read the data with the package read R. Here is a set of important options. We can change the name, what they said name there, or modify anything if we want, but for now, we're going to leave it like that. Here, there is a code preview which show us the code need to import the data. So that's why we can learn how to do it. So after that, we just press import, and the data will get imported. So here's the data already imported. And there is a preview of the data now in the console. In the left, We have the environment window in which we see that we have a data frame already or a table. It said that it got over 19,000 observations at 11 variables. Then in the console, we can see the code used for importing the data set. So this is something that we can just copy this code and on our screen so we can save it for later. The not easy way of doing that is just writing the code like that. I'm just importing, in the example, I'm importing the same data set. I just change the name to family and I run the code and I got two data sets. I wanted to show you that either way of importing data is fine. If you want to do code, you do code. If you want to do something easier and just ask RStudio and clicking on RStudio for doing it, just do that. There is no problem with that. Either way works fine. R has a particular way of working. So to perform any operation or any variable, we need to use a specific name of the data frame and that we're using every time. So for instance, there is an example here for the family when I'm using the function class of the family data set for the variable age. So in this code, the function is class that gives us the type of variable, such as character, numeric, or whatever. Then we write the function followed by a bracket, and then we specify the data frame that we are using, in this case, family. Then you can see a dollar sign there, which is a data structure, which is followed by the variable age, that is basically the variable that we wanted to use. It's a bit inconvenient, but you get used to this very quickly. So after running the function, the result that I get is the class or the type of variable that age is, and it said that is a variable, a numeric variable. Now I want you to show you the same, but using R directly. This is RStudio screen. I have my script here. If you want to open, you want to create a new script, you just go to new file and then press script and you're going to get a script here. If you want to open another script, just open file and search in your folder. This already there. So for instance, for the working directory that I showed you before, you go to session, set working directory, and choose directory, and then start looking for the file that you want. Or you can just use the code like this one. I'm just selecting this and pressing run, and the working directory is set. I want to know where my working directory is, I just use the function get working directory. You can only click on this. You don't need to select, but if you want select, just select and press run. And then R is telling me where my working directory is. So for install packages, you can use the code here. This is the code, install packages. You can install more than one package at a time, so we can do this actually. But I already have installed these packages, so I'm not going to install them now. Or you can go to tools, install packages, and then this window is going to appear. You look for the package. And then press install. Once the package is installed, you have to load them like that. Bring it run. Then if they said attaching packages, all the packages related with Tidyverse. When install the package happen, and the package foreign. And now we can use all these three packages in our analysis. So this is just, for example, how a variable works. This is, I'm creating a variable. You can see the variable A with the value 3 is there. If I type here in the console A, I'm going to get the value. here I'm creating more variables. We can do some operation with this. Say this one, over here, and we can save it in another variable, the variable D. We want to see what the variable D is. And all of these are here stored in the global environment. So, okay, loading and importing data. We have this code here that we can use, or I'm gonna show you here how to use it. Here you can see my working directory. We can move here actually and explore. This is the data set that I want to import. So I just click on it once. There is the two options, view file and import data set. I'm going to import data set. And I get this screen. So here, for instance, I can change the name. I'm going to put just data. And it's going to just change here. Yeah. So now I can just import the data. You can see the code is here in the console. You can copy. Here you can see that we have in the global environment the new data set data, and here we can see a preview of the data. If we use the code, it's basically the same code. I'm going to install the same data set, family composition, but just by code. And you can see it's the same data set, just two ways of importing the same data. So using functions, for instance, class, as I told you before, is a function that tells us the type of data or the structure that we have. And the class of family is here is a data frame or a table. It has four different attributes. The class of the variable age belonging to the dataset family is, numeric, or the variable sex is character. Here's dataset. You can see age here, or sex, male, female, so it's character, age, just number. So that's what is numeric. The class of twin sister is numeric as well. Is this? So what else? Some basic analysis that you can do. Summary is just like to get central tendency of any numeric variable. Summary of age. We get here in the console the result. We have a median of 21.3, a mean of 27. We're gonna ask for instance this value here, NA, is telling us that there are some missing variables, 283. So we can get the standard deviation, for instance. We use family. RStudio also is good because it's giving you some hint of what we want to use. So we can family, and then we can search for the variable. And then we get NA here. This is something that is very common. We're gonna get that because we have missing values. So we need to use another function here. This is na.rm, which means basically remove all the missings, and we put true, and then we can run it again, and we have the standard deviation for the variable. For non-numeric variables like nominal, we can have a frequency table. We use the function table. We run, and then we have how many female and female we have in the data set. So, this is what I wanted to show you with the demonstration. Now let's back. So, to recap of what we have seen, First of all, when you start with R, don't forget to set your working directory, first thing. Then install and load all the packages that you're gonna need. Obviously, you can load more packages as you are doing more analysis if you need them, but remember, always install the packages, otherwise, then the function, your analysis are not gonna work. Third, you have to import the data. You have to use the write function for the write data that you have, depending on the format. Give your data a name, so you can then perform any operation with those. Just remember that R is case sensitive. So for instance, be careful with capital letters, be careful with spaces, and all of those kind of things that sometimes are problematic. Another advice is just when you are naming a data set, use an easy to type name, because you have to type it every time. Remember, when they name the data set, then the name of the variable. So choose something short and informative. So where to go if you're stuck? Well, basically, another thing that I wanted to tell you is that the only way to learn R is just try and error. Try, and probably lot of errors, lot of them, yes. Since I said before that R has a huge community online, so there's also a lot of resources online. I've just highlighted some of them here. I put a link for the book R for Data Science, that it's completely available online with some exercise and nice explanation. There are other resources like Quick R or Stack Overflow that are really good, because in Stack Overflow you can ask questions or see other questions that people have asked about R and how to do things. Yeah, so follow these links. There's no shame in copy. If you see a code on the online of someone that is doing something similar to you, just copy that code and modify it to your purposes, change the name of the data, the name of the variables, and then you can use it. That's the way for learning.